Hello, children. Are you ready for some cutting up and kikiing? Are you ready for a gay old time? Well, I hope you are, because now it's time for Hey Queen with your host, Johnny McGovern.
Hey Queen, come on and spill the tea. Hey Queen, it's just a good old fashioned kiki. Hey Queen, we're cutting up with Johnny.
My little gay angels, and welcome to another divine episode of
Hey Queen
with me, Johnny McGovern. We have another large and in charge episode for you today. The one, the only, Miss Delta Work will be joining us. But before we bring her out, there's another BBWWIAAM. That's Big Beautiful Woman, who's also a man, that I have to introduce. She's like a giant box of Cracker Jacks with an even bigger prize inside. She's put more than one all-you-can-eat buffet out of business, so you better watch out. And her favorite food is salad, if you replace all the vegetables with meat. It's Miss Lady Red Couture! Hey!
Hey!
Hey, Queen!
Hey, Queen!
Oh, should I say hello, voodoo priestess?
Or we should just talk in my native tongue.
Oh, okay. Would you like me to greet you in click language?
What did you just call me?
Oh, man, sorry. My pronunciation must have been off. You look great.
Thank you so much.
You look like you're going to cast a spell.
Baby, I feel all right. I mean, it's a little short for me.
Oh, well, it's because you're used to being on the Serengeti when they don't wear panties in the Serengeti. So it's fine. You came back to civilization and you're like, oh, my Africa dress is so short. My Africa dress. Letting it fly free in the African breezes down there.
I love it though, honey. Yes.
And you're wearing your blood diamond.
Yes, of course. Of course. This is one of them dresses you can secretly jack off and nobody will know.
Oh.
You just do it from the back.
All right then. Oh. All right then. We just learned a little extra about Lady Red. If you ever see her with a hand missing and a leg up, you know something. Interesting's going on. Oh, girl, I know you're feeling a little under the weather today.
Oh, yeah, I'm just trying to keep it together. You know, we have been doing a lot lately.
We have been nonstop, darling.
And although I love that, my body is like, hey, bitch, fuck you.
Yo,
like,
bitch.
Calm down, bitch.
Calm down.
Yeah.
Last night I had to drug you.
Oh, yeah.
I had to drug you.
Yeah, and I wanted to argue with you about it, but I didn't have the strength.
I was like, you're like, I'm not feeling well. I'm like, all right, you're going to take this and this and this and this and the sleeping pill and then get to bed.
You was like a
pusher. Stop trolling for thugs on the internet. You need to sleep.
Well, you know, I sleep with all three of my phones.
I know you do. You're like, what's up, player? What's up, thug? Yo, thug. I'm like, put them down. Take this Tylenol PM, this Advil PM, this painkiller, the CQ10,
all of that.
I'm like, I need you strong.
Yes, honey.
I put my own spell on you, my own voodoo spell, medicine spell. You're healed. You're healed for just today. We have been doing a lot. We've been traveling.
Yes.
Now, let me tell you something. It's very, very fun for us to travel around together, and it's very fun for me to see the reaction of the world to Lady Red in public places, especially at the airport.
Oh my God. I just thought it was gonna be, you know, see, cause I haven't flown in like 15 years.
Yes.
So I'm used to the Greyhound.
Yes, you are.
You know what I mean? So you could bring a little with you, you know what
you
I'm
can.
Saying? Hey, no problem, just put an oregano jar and you know, you good.
Right.
But the airport ain't like that now.
Not at the airport,
it's
no.
Search and seizure, baby.
That's right, I said Lady Red, just so you know, it's not just a metal detector anymore. There's a thing, you go in and it scans your whole body.
Right, and part of me didn't believe you at first, so I had a little something under my wig.
Uh-huh.
And then as we went to leave out the door, something said, take that shit out your wig, bitch.
Yes.
So I did, so.
Wise decision.
I was happy though, because when I got there, you know, even the lady, she, you know, they put me through the little thing, they made me throw up the Hova sign. You know,
right.
You're sitting there. Mm-hmm. Right, so then I go through and the woman's like, I have to check you. And I'm like, you still have to check me? She was like, yeah, there's some, you know, she showed me the screen. So then she's like, right here, which was right here, right here.
Uh-huh.
I was like, those are pads. She said, okay. And she said, and your wig? I said, well, come on. She said, well, you're taller than me, so I'm going to try it. I said, okay, it's just pins. So she's, okay, all right, go ahead. I was like, ooh,
they have to get a step stool to get on top of your head.
I'm just glad I had took that out of my wig.
Yeah, I'm glad, too, because that would have been a very sad story when I had to be like, bye, Lady Red. I'll call Walter to get you out of jail.
Okay, I wouldn't have been mad because I'd have rolled it up right there and smoked it. Like, taking me to jail? Go ahead, hurry up.
Take me away, motherfucker.
I'm ready to go, Kai. I'm ready to go.
I'm ready to get laid, so take me to jail. Finally, I get all the thugs that I want.
Okay, put me in general population, I dare you.
Take me to the showers, motherfucker. Well, we got your old homegirl on the show today.
Yeah.
Miss Delta Work is here.
One of the first people that ever hired me when I started doing drag out here. Yes, out in Long Beach when she had her big girl show.
Mm-hmm.
She was one of the first people who actually welcomed me, didn't treat me shady.
Mm-hmm.
The girl even went in her closet and gave me clothes. And I mean, I couldn't fit them because I was fat as hell. But it was nice to just re-sew it. You know what I mean?
Oh, right. Yeah, yes. You showed me that. You've worn it on this show before. You wore it on the Andrew Christian episode.
Honey.
It was a black dress and she gave you and said?
Well, she said, go do something with it. So I did. You know what I mean? And then she always takes care of me. Just treat me so good. You don't get that a lot. That's why that's my fam bam. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Not everybody's my fam bam.
No, that's for sure.
Once you in, you win, cuz. You in. You got to get jumped out. No.
Don't mess with Lady Rand, cuz if she likes you and then don't like you, you got to get jumped out. Well, luckily, Delta Work does not have to get jumped out.
No.
And we'll be back with her after this very gay break. Yay!
Hey, Queen!
Hey, Queen! Wait, what am I wearing? Yes, I'm wearing the official Hey Queen t-shirt, now available at heyqueen.com. Yes! Whenever you want to walk into a room and have people know you're a queen, you'll wear this shirt, and what they say to you will be what is on your shirt. They'll say, hey, Queen! Also available, hi, Gwen, and other fun things. And wait a second, there's a supermodel, and she's also wearing one of our new shirts. Bam!
Look at her!
Lady Red, I love your look at her t-shirt, available at heyqueen.com.
Yes, you better get it. Get them while they're hot, honey.
Mm-hmm. If you want people to look at you or know you're a queen or say, hey, queen, or look at her, these are the shirts to wear. Plus, you'll be supporting Lady Red and I's broke asses by buying the shirts.
Sure,
so do that. We also have Hey Gwen, a cutting up in Kiki, a whole bunch of other fun designs, all available at heyqueen.com for a reasonable price.
Yes.
So click, click, click and buy your Hey Queen, look at her, hi Gwen, cutting up in Kiki, hello children, all the fun things you love about Hey Queen, available on t-shirts for you to wear and rep yo Hey Queen homies.
Go get them nails, kids.
Yeah, honey, yeah. Our guest today is a season 3 Drag Race super favorite, a drag veteran, and an all-around hot-ass queen. Let's take a look at her latest World of Wonder series.
Delta, 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 can I help you, help you, help you? Hi, everyone. Welcome to Dear Delta. Each week, I'll be answering your questions about health, love, success, etiquette, food, fashion, earrings, finger rings, and how not to be a douche. And if these answers don't work for you, I don't give a fuck.
Hey, Queen!
And here she is, Delta Work!
Yeah!
Hey, Queen!
Hey, Queen!
Well, look at you.
How are you?
I'm good. You just look like a nice lady next door.
Well, I have a Tupperware party later, so.
Oh, you do?
Yeah.
I figure you and your big titties came around to sell Tupperware. I'd
Tiggle
buy
bitties.
Tupperware from you any day.
Tiggle bitties. I have these two, and then I have a set in the back, too.
Oh, good. It's always good to have an extra set of titties.
Those are for dancing.
So you have a new series on World of Wonder Presents. It's Dear Delta.
It's called Dear Delta, and it's basically kind of like a Dear Abby. Or an Ann Landers, but just a little more real. People tweet me questions about I don't know, social media or fashion or something like that, and then I just sort of answer them with a shot of realness.
Of harsh reality.
Yeah, of harsh reality. Well, you know, I don't want to be mean, but I think people want you to be honest.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes they need brutal honesty.
Mm-hmm.
And I just was sitting around one day and I was like, you know what? I'm just so fucking right about everything. I need to take letters.
Yes, you do.
I'm just so right.
And teach the children.
Yeah.
Lady Red, are you excited to see this lady right here?
You already know. When she speaks, bitch, I'll be quiet.
Well, and that's rare.
Hell yeah, that's rare.
That is very beautiful. It's wonderful to see drag sisters reunited again.
Yes.
So what is some of the craziest questions you've gotten so far in Dear Delta?
Well, there's been people that have asked, and I haven't answered them yet. I mean, I've answered them in my mind. I file them all.
You file them away in the Delta work file.
And then we decide what really is going to make the most impact. Who's going to maybe also share that question. So someone asked what the proper way was to douche.
Oh, yeah. I mean, that is important
to
know.
There is a proper way. There is a proper way.
There is a proper way. And if you are a bottom, you should know it.
You should know.
And actually, if you're a top, you should also know in case you were the bottom that doesn't know, and you can show them.
100%. So I'm going to do a tutorial, essentially.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, a lot of girls do makeup tutorials and hair tutorials. I'm going to do douching tutorials because I think people want to know. People want to know, and they deserve to know from the horse's ass.
I mean, slow clap to standing ovation. Finally, a useful series. No, it's funny, when I saw you this morning, you were telling me you've been to the building our studio is in before, many years ago, pre-Drag Race, and you had a funny story about it.
I came here to do a photo shoot, my first professional photo shoot, even before Drag Race, before any of that, and I was so excited. I was like, this person invited me, and I wasn't paying for it either.
Mm-hmm.
And I gassed up at home, and I got my soda, and I was ready to go, and I drove here, did the photo shoot. Bye, thank you so much, I had such a wonderful time. Drove away, and my car died in the alley because I never filled up the tank. I paid, and I didn't fill up the tank.
Oh, no.
And that was like my last 50 bucks.
Oh, no.
Truly. And so, you know, we're kind of in the area in between Little Armenia and Trannyville.
Oh, right.
We're not allowed to say that, are we? Well, it's already been said. In any event. T.S.ville.
T.S.ville, okay.
And, you know, I was in drag because I left here at the photo shoot and I was going to go do a show. So I was already kind of done up. And
right.
A kind gentleman offered to bring me some gas.
Oh.
Well, fuel.
Because you were pushing your car.
I was pushing my car in drag.
Yes.
In drag, trying to get it back up in the thing. And yeah, it was a big, hairy, ugly, dirty mess. So, you know, when I came in here, I was having like DDTs. Cause I was like, it's not that building. I don't want to go in that building.
I don't want to have it happen again. But lucky you met a kind gentleman who was like, hello, you're very beautiful. I will to find you gas.
He found my gas all right. He found my gas. He did. But now, you know, I'm a millionaire and I don't have that problem.
She's rich. She's got that season 3 money, honey.
All that money. I'm rich.
She got that hell of this money, honey.
Which my ring even says #1 rich.
Oh, I do love that ring. Yes.
I mean, if you're not, you might as well just tell people you are by wearing a plastic ring.
Nothing like rich. Rich people love to wear things that say rich.
Right. You have to let people know.
Mm-hmm. So you were on season 3, but you've managed to keep yourself out there and constantly working and doing it and traveling. And it did help that you had your little super group of the Heathers as well.
You know what? It's been a blessing and it's been, you know, sometimes it's a detriment and sometimes it's, you know, the thing about the Heathers is that it was that moment.
Right.
So we had that moment. But, you know, people aren't really there for the duration of the taping of something and don't realize that happening simultaneously. So what seems like something really, really major could be something small, but mm-hmm. it's something people relate to.
Mm-hmm.
And so on some level, people, you know, right after that was sort of the, resurgence of, like, bullying. Everyone was talking about bullying right after that.
Right.
And so we were the drag bullies, essentially. And that wasn't our goal. Our goal was to be silly and make this reference one morning and then tease about it. And it just became more than that. So I, you know, left the show and was kind of labeled a bully, which, you know, I don't know if I'm a bully or other people are pussies. I think it could be that.
That's what it could be.
The good thing, though, about Drag Race is that kind of after a while, you kind of forget about it. And the only thing left is that brand name of the Heathers.
Right.
When y'all can go on tour together and have gigs together and do all that kind of stuff.
We have. You know, there's people, I mean, essentially, Manila, Carmen, Raja, myself, we were all outcasts in school. We decided that, you know, by doing drag, we sort of became, you know, top of the game. By being cast on the show, it felt like you were top of the game.
Yeah.
So it's like you reclaim that. You reclaim that. And you're like, yeah, Raja was an awkward, gangly sort of person. Manila was, you know, is half Filipino, half Jewish. Carmen, you know, always knowing that she was a woman inside. Mm-hmm. Myself being like the awkward fat boy, never picked. Why couldn't we be whoever we wanted to be? And why couldn't we bring everyone along and say, you can be Heather as well.
Right.
You can be this privileged white girl if that's what you want to be. You know what I mean?
You hear that, Lady Red?
You can too.
You can be a privileged white, rich white woman.
Oh no, I believe it. I believe it. I was just so happy that they put her on, because I remember us standing in the line for season 3. And then she went in and she came out. I was like, you okay? Everything happened? She's like, oh, I'm fine. Talk to you later. Then I was like, she got on.
We did. That was a crazy audition.
Oh, did you guys wait outside online together?
Yes, we were all in line down, what is that, Cherokee and Hollywood Boulevard.
Yes. Right.
And we waited, and it was the sweatiest day ever.
Oh, my God.
And they took us in groups. And they took, like, Venus was in the group before me.
Uh-huh.
Didn't they team us up, like, in different, like, there was, like, maybe 6 girls at a time.
Yeah.
And they wanted to just respond to, you know, see who was kind of the standout of those groups, and then eliminate them and say, come back later at 3, you know, and
yes,
so everyone's in drag, basically, there's nowhere to sit.
On the street!
Yeah, it was brutal.
Hollywood!
In Full Heels,
it was brutal.
Yes. Wow, and that's when they were doing open calls, where you had to wait and get in.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Wow.
It was crazy, but, you know, it's been such, it's like I said, it's a blessing, and then there's, you know, there's, I want to say, for some people, there's bad things that come.
Uh-huh.
You know, there's the attacks, and there's the, I think anybody that's going to be in the limelight, that's going to happen to you, whether you're a celebrity or a sub-lebrity.
Right.
You know what I mean? And if you just do drag in general, you're going to have people that come to the bar that are your friends or fans, as you like to call them.
Yeah.
And you can't focus on that. And I spent a lot of time focusing on that.
Oh, did you?
When I left Drag Race, I spent a lot of time responding to people. I would set my Diet Coke there and set my bag of Doritos. And I was like, okay, what did you say? Respond. But it's so pointless, because those people, you will, in many cases, you may meet them. And when you meet them, they will never mention it. And they'll be the first person to ask for a picture.
Yeah.
And can you sign this? Mm-hmm. And I love you so much.
Uh-huh.
And you're my favorite of the big girls. Or you're my favorite of the whatever, you know, which I don't know if it's such a blessing for someone to say, you're my favorite of, I don't know, do people say to you, Red, you're my favorite of the black girls? They won't say that.
They won't say that.
Nobody says to Raja, you're my favorite of the tall girls.
Right.
They sure say, oh, you're my favorite of the fat girls. Well, I want to be your favorite in general.
Yeah.
I want you to say, you know what, you're my
That's
favorite.
That's right.
Oh, yes, mild applause is the best guy.
Yeah.
You're right about that.
Don't you want to be a favorite?
Of course.
And you know, you don't have to have one favorite. You can have like a bunch.
Yeah.
You can say, you are all my favorites.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes.
It must be interesting because Drag Race kind of like had spread around the world, country by country, people are still discovering your season every couple of year, every couple months even. Yep. Like different countries are getting it. And they're mad at you again. And they love you again.
I never really thought about that. I never thought about that, but you can tell, because you'll get fan. I have like a regular Facebook account and then a fan page.
Of course.
That when I left Drag Race, Rhea Latre made it for me.
Oh, God bless her.
Rhea has always been like into that. You know what I mean? She's the one that got me into social media, which I'm if you're mad, blame her, because
blame, you know, Rhea.
And so I'm active. I'm mostly active on my regular page, but that limits you to 5,000 people.
Right.
And then my fan page, I would like to be more active on it, but honestly, there's no traffic on that page, and no one cares. I'd rather just engage with the 5,000 people there and post my ridiculous stuff about Taco Bell or whatever I post.
Yes.
Because I feel like I'm getting that response. But what I'm getting at, basically, is that when they do start airing it in other countries, you'll get fan mail from just those places.
Right.
And it never dawned on me until you said that right now. Like, why is everybody from Germany saying this? Or, was, you know, lately it's been like people from like Egypt or whatever trying to get a date.
Wow. You know? The Delta! I love you, meet me at the pyramids!
Yeah, I think Egyptian dudes, I think there's a lot of like.
Oh, yeah,
chasers.
You are. I lived in Egypt as a kid, so you are the standard of Egyptian.
Oh, is this it?
Thick beauty, darling! They're like, Habibi!
I could be a princess or a queen or stuff for real.
Yes! Let's talk about Dreamgirls. You've been the famous review, the drag review, now based in West Hollywood, but started long ago in San Diego by Chad Michaels, Hunter. What's Hunter's last name?
Well, Hunter just went by Hunter.
Hunter just went by Hunter. And then the dearly departed Kiwi and Marilyn, right? Mm-hmm. And they started it in the early 90s?
Well, the original person who started the Dreamgirls was Nicole the Great.
Okay.
Yeah, so Nicole started the Dreamgirls, as far as I know. Mm-hmm. It's so long ago.
That's a long time.
And I've been part of Dreamgirls for what? Close to 15 years.
15 years.
Yeah, and I remember, you know, Chad brought me in when I was like super boogery, but let me fill in a little bit, uh-huh. and was like, you know, I can help you with this. And so Chad was sort of fairy godmother, and Hunter was sort of like the mean godmother because he was very strict. He used to do bag checks.
Oh,
he
really?
He would come in and he would say, because we would, you know, we do production numbers sometimes.
Yeah.
There's wardrobe that you have to be mindful of. So he would come in and say, well, do you have black pumps? Do you have nude pumps? Do you have boots? Do you have a black bra? And you need to have all those things. And it was almost like being in like Boy Scouts.
Right.
You know, if you don't have your shit, you're probably not going to be working. Yeah. Even if you didn't need it that night. Yeah. It was like, you still have to be prepared.
Be prepared.
Yeah. And you know, at Dreamgirls, we do celebrity impersonation, celebrity assassination.
Yes, you do.
You know, we're known for like funny mixes, current stuff, but you know, you still kind of want to do your thing.
Yeah.
As much as you want to kind of fit in with that. So it's changed quite a bit, and we've added a lot of girls, and unfortunately along the way we've lost some girls that gave us a framework. So we still have that framework, and in that way they live with the show. But we've added a lot of girls in. We have a venue in San Diego, which is the home of the Dreamgirls. We also have our show at Hamburger Mary's in Long Beach.
Right.
We have our show at Rage on Tuesdays.
Yes.
And we are hopefully going to be opening a show at the new Hamburger Mary's in Ontario.
Oh, that would be good.
We're excited.
Very good.
But we've been, you know, we were at MJ's.
I remember good old MJ's.
Right?
Yeah.
Like all over. So we've had, you know, at any given time, there's been a time where we had five venues in a week. And then, of course, your other gigs that you're doing. So
I mean, that keeps you working.
It keeps us working. And, you know, I try to keep scheduled out with national appearances based on the appearance on RuPaul's Drag Race.
Yeah.
But I'm fortunate that I work and produce anywhere between 5 and 6 shows a week, you know, here. Myself and Chad, Dolly, you know, we produce the shows, and then I work in other people's shows. So I'm happy to be part of the sort of gay drag queen mafia in Southern California, where you're like, I want to work there, I want to work there, I want to work there, and you kind of know where you're going to be. But it's tough because those cast spots, there's only so many.
Yeah.
And you have people that you've worked with forever, and you want to bring other people in, but you have to ask somebody to not work.
Right.
And you're like, who is going to sacrifice their money? Because I sure as shit ain't.
Well, I'm ready for you to fire some bitch and give Lady Red a gig. I
Red
want some Dreamgirls.
Red shuts it down.
She does. She needs a spot.
The thing about Red is that she does something that nobody else does.
Mm-hmm.
And Red shows love while she's performing. And that's important to me. Because there's people that just go out and they like grab money. I just want money. I just want money. I just want money. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna stop performing. I'm gonna stop lip syncing or whatever. Because you know, I'm nobody's dancer. I'm nobody's real lookalike. Any of those things. But I find my way around it to make it work for me and like carve out my niche or what people are now calling brand.
Right.
Which like annoys the shit out of me when people are like, my brand is this. My brand is this. And I'm like, why don't you just be authentic? Why don't you just do what you do and then let a group of people decide what you're doing as a brand and then let them buy into it instead of saying this is my brand but never achieving it.
Yeah.
Like just achieve it. Just do it. Just don't say it. Be it. You know what I mean?
And show it.
People will love it or they won't love it. But as long as you're doing your thing, you know, I never wanted to be famous, but I always thought it would be cool and have cred to be infamous for something.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I don't want to just have people go, just go speak these, just go do this, but not be authentic about it. I want it to be real. I want people, you know, when people many times speak in third person.
Right.
And I know that's some people's thing and that's what they enjoy or whatever, but some people say, oh, don't you just want to be Gabriel sometimes? And I'm like, Gabriel, Delta, it's the same to me, whether I'm in or out of drag.
Right.
I feel like I'm the same person.
Yeah.
I get it if I'm, maybe you're playing a role or maybe you're doing a funny number, a performance or something, but essentially, you're always talking to the same person, whether I'm in and out of drag. So when people call, I mean, my mom doesn't call me Delta, obviously.
Right.
But, you know, it's just, it's like, be authentic. That's all, that's my thing. I enjoy that. And that's the thing about Red, is Red is authentic. She is for real.
She show is. Ding, show ding.
Is. I mean, except for obvious.
Except for all of you.
You're super fake. We're super fake in the same areas.
Okay.
But,
now, you are filling a lot on the fashion review. You do that. It's you, Raja, and Raven. You guys sort of switch in and around.
Raja and Raven are the hosts of Fashion Photo Review, but they try to film the episodes a couple at a time, so sometimes one of them is not available.
Right, a gal's on tour, call up Delta.
So they call in myself, they've called in Tammy Brown, Gia Gunn, Morgan.
All good. Wonderful.
So it's really, really fun to do, but, you know, it's hard to be honest about something without sounding terribly mean.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, essentially these girls sign off and they know they're going to be trolled by us.
Right.
And I take a little more liberty sometimes because, I don't know, I feel like you should kind of bring it.
Why not?
I feel like you should bring it, especially if you're a girl who's making thousands of dollars when you go out there to perform.
Uh-huh.
And you are, you know, known for great live performances or character illusions or whatever it is that you're known for. But, you know, sometimes these pictures are stuff we just grab from Instagram. And
right.
I have plenty of pictures from Instagram where I look like a straight-up boog.
And you got in trouble recently with Miss Adore Delano.
We did.
Because you gave her a boot, and she wanted a motherfucking tooth.
We did. Well, you know, I will say for Adore, I don't think Adore really wanted anybody's approval, and I admire that.
Yeah.
Because who needs anybody's approval?
She's a rock and roll diva. She don't need nothing.
She sells out venues. She can back it up. Her album is sickening.
So good.
You know, I just wanted her to, like, I don't know, put on a ring and.
What was the look that you guys didn't like?
I think she was maybe wearing a jersey, and she was wearing like a jersey and
nothing
else. A colorful wig, and I think she had like some boots, some combat boots on or whatever. But you know, but honestly, somebody could have pulled up that picture of me in the old lady wig, and they could have been like, "Well, what about you? I didn't boot this shit," you know? It could have been that situation. Who knows? But you know, these girls are essentially, they know they're being trolled.
Mm-hmm.
They know we're just gonna talk shit. They know they're making thousands of dollars.
Yes, Adore's too rich to care, but she did write a rap about y'all.
She said she included a little bit in there when she was out of town, but she did say it when she was wearing a beautiful, beautiful outfit and beautiful crystal heels. And so, I mean, the message got out there.
All right,
honey.
Then you gave a little bit and she gave it back.
It comes full circle. It comes full circle. We all look great and awful at any given time.
Don't I know it?
Honey.
You have a new song that's coming, that's out probably right now, The Walking Blues, Walk Right In, Walk Right Out.
It is.
It's a song from the 50s that you remade.
It's out by J Red Music,
uh-huh.
And Darren Burgos and Paulo Ramirez did the beat in the back, and it's kind of like a dubstep.
Okay.
And there's a rap I wrote in the middle, and it's essentially, it's kind of music that I like to perform as well. It's that type of music, but we just rewrote it a little bit. And it's what they used to have in the like early 50s called innuendo music, which was songs where blues singers would suggest something. So they would suggest like, you know, berries for their pussy, or they would suggest their melons for their boobs. So it's that kind of song.
Yeah.
So every time there's like a cuss word in the song where it's supposed to rhyme, it cuts off
and
it goes into the chorus.
Uh-huh.
So it's fun. I like it. And it was from, I think, 1952 originally. Mm. So, yeah.
Can you give me a little taste of your rap?
Let's see. Okay. I think there's a part in the middle where it says, "For goodness sake, it makes my body shake. Earthquake, 300-pound kick. Body built for heartbreak."
Yeah!
Right?
Yes.
And you know, I'm not a singer, obviously, you just saw. But I was like, fuck, I've got to be, you know, you've got to get on Like Rue says, you can't miss it. That's you have one opportunity. You cannot miss it. So even like when you're watching Drag Race, there's people that can't sew, but they can use a glue gun.
Yes.
There's people that can't dance, but they can keep time. Mm-hmm. There's people that can't really stomp the runway, but they can make it their own when they go down. So I was like, well, how about this? How about I just get a sickening DJ to make a sickening beat, and then I just talk my shit over it.
Yes, honey.
Because essentially someone will dance to it or at least laugh at it.
Exactly.
I'll take $1.29 either way.
Bravo! Delta, it's been so great having you on the show.
Thank you.
You've been so sickening, the darling. You snatched your trophy, honey! Yay!
Yay! Thank you!
Yes, and you've also won yourself, I hope your boyfriend won't mind, a lap dance!
I'll take it!
Yay!
Oh, we matched!
Right. We matched! Oh, you do, it's so beautiful! Give it your gun, come on, Nala! Get in there, pussy!
Ooh.
Get in there!
Ooh.
Get in there, yeah!
Oh, wow!
Lady Red, take us out with some black lady screaming.
Hey, queen. Hey, la, la, la. Hey, queen. Hey, queen. Hey. Oh, he smells
good.
Hey, 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 queen.
Yes. He smells good?
He took a shower.
Now, don't forget, we're going to play, Look at Her with Delta in the Hey Queen After Show. So make sure you click the link at the end of the thing and go right there. Thank you, Delta. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, Lady Red. Bye, Queen. Bye. Bye, Queen. Bye, Queen.
Bye, Queen. These are adorable. Marco makes the best stuff.
I know that is. Your butt looks great.
Hey, 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 queen.